We continue now at the top of Daf Samech Ches Amud Aleph of Masechet Shabbos. This is Shabbos Daf 68a. The Mishnah just said that if somebody knows that it's Shabbos, he knows about Shabbos, but multiple Shabbosos, he does multiple Av Melachos. So the Mishnah said he's chayev on every Av Melacha u'Melacha. He's chayev on every single Av Melacha. Rashi here explains Av Melacha denokat lav lemute todos. We don't mean to say over here that if the person knows that it's Shabbos and he violates Shabbos, he's chayev only on every Av Melacha and not on the todos. Dehu adin letodos. The truth is he's chayev on todos as well. Uvelvad shehu todos to shnei avos. But Rashi says it has to be todos of two separate avos. El lemutehecha david beis todos davecha. The only thing it's excluding is if a person violated two todos of one av. O av v'tolda shalo, or he does an av and it's tolda, de'eno chayev ela achas, is only chayev one in such a case. Kedekatani seifa osa malachas harbe me'ein malacha achas shtei toldos shalav echad eno chayev ela chatas achas. That's essentially what the seifa of the Mishnah says. Darei uka osa v'chozer v'osa behalamecha, that's considered like one forgetting, so to speak. V'ein chilek chatos behalamecha ela begufe aveira shein and domin o bechilek shabosos lenin shigas shabbos. He says the only time that you get separate carbon chatos is if you do malachas that are not similar to one another, they're part of separate avos, or he has separate violations in terms of Shigas Shabbos, so he forgets multiple times Shabbos, so then each Shabbos is going to be its own violation, and that's the end of the Mishnah we just quoted. Ha'osa malachas harbe me'ein malacha achas. If a person does many malachas that are all encompassed under one malacha, meaning they're all one av, they're all encompassed under one av, eino chayev ela chatas achas. In such a situation, he's only chayev one carbon chatas. So the Gemara asks, Mai tai matana klal gadol. What's the reason why we call this a klal gadol? Right, these rules are a great general rule when it comes to Hilchos Shabbos. What's with the word gadol? Now, if the reason is because later on in this perek, we're going to have another, a klal acher. Rashi here explains, od klal acher, another general rule. In that Mishnah of od klal acher, there's only two things there. Here we have a little more klalos. So maybe that's why it's called gadol, because we're going to have a klal acher, which is a smaller Mishnah. So this larger Mishnah is called klal gadol. So if that's the case, again, Ilay Mishnah the Kavoy Lemisni Od Klal Acher Tana Klal Gadol, because the next Mishnah is going to say Od Klal Acher, therefore here we say it's Klal Gadol. V'gabe Shvias Naami Mishnah the Kavoy Lemisni Od Klal Acher Tana Klal Gadol. When it comes to Shvias as well, the Mishnais and Shvias also use this language of Klal Gadol because there's an Od Klal Acher. So that's a nice answer. However, v'gabe Meiser de Katani Klal Acher V'lotani Klal Gadol. When it comes to in Mishnais and Meisers, they have a klal acher, and it never says klal gadol. So that wouldn't explain why we don't use the same terminology in Maseches Meisers. So Amar Rav Yossi Bar Avin, Rav Yossi Bar Avin answers Shabbos u'Shvias de'isbu avos v'toldos. When it comes to both Shabbos and Shvias, they have the concept of avos and toldos. So tana gadol. That's why we learn the term gadol. Meiser, the lesba avos v'toldos, when it comes to Meiser, where there is not avos and toldos, lotana klal gadol. We don't have this language of klal gadol. Rashi here explains, isbe avos arboim chaser achas. We know on Shabbos there's 39 avos malachas, shehutzrachu l'mishkan, they come from the mishkan. V'toldos hadomos l'chol achas have v'toldos didei. And what are the toldos? The toldos are things that are similar to those avos. What about Shemitah? So avos to Shviyas Zeria uktzira. When it comes to Uzmiru Vitzira, when it comes to Shemitah year, you have planting and harvesting and pruning and gathering. Those are all avos. Techsivan, those are written in the Torah. Toldos shar avodos shebesod v'kerem kedamin v'moikot and parakama. The toldos are other avodos that people do, other kinds of work that people do in fields and in vineyards, and those are taught in the first parak of Moed Katan. So you have avos and toldos by Shabbos, and you have avos and toldos by Shvias, but you don't have that by Meiser, so maybe that's the answer. So then the Gemara says, though, well, that's a good answer. However, ulavar kapara detani klal gadol b'meiser. However, bar kapara, he had his own tosefta that he taught when it came to Meisers, and he has the words klal gadol. And there's no avos and toldos for that. My avos and my toldos ika. You don't have avos and toldos. So for bar kapara, with this tosefta that he taught, we don't have, this answer doesn't hold. So the Gemara instead gives a different answer. El alav hainu taima gadol onshel shel Shabbos yoser mishel Shvias. So rather, what's the reason? The reason is because the punishment on Shabbos is greater than the punishment for Shvius. Why? De'ilu Shabbos isa bein betalush bein mechubur. Because when it comes to Shabbos, you have isurim whether things are detached from the ground, whether they are attached to the ground. Ve'ilu Shvius betalush less of mechubur isa. When it comes to Shemitah, when it comes to Shvius, there's no dinim by talush, there's dinim by mechubur. So therefore, there's a certain stringency in the punishment of Shabbos over Shvius. The gadol onshe shel Shvius yoser min ha-maiser, and when it comes to Shvius also, the punishment of Shvius is greater than Meiser. De'ilu Shvius isa bein me'maychol adam bein me'maychol behema. Because when it comes to Shvius, that applies to food that's human food and food that's animal food. Ve'ilu Meiser be'maychol adam isa be'maychol behema lesser. When it comes to Meiser, it applies to human food. It does not apply to Meiser food. So therefore, you have, it's called a klal gadol because it's greater than the other case. Shabbos is greater than Shvius, so it's called klal gadol. Shvius is greater than Meiser, so it's called klal gadol, but Meiser is not greater than anything. That's essentially what the Gemara is suggesting. Rashi explains some of these stringencies. Elalav hainu taimim mishum avos v'toldos. It's not because of avos v'toldos. Eladavar shenemar b'klal v'oncho gadol midavar acher. Anytime there's something where we have a klal, and the punishment is greater than some other thing, shenemar b'klal, where it also says the word klal, tani be klal gadol. We use the language of klal gadol. So it's like a funny rule, but basically anytime you have the word klal, and that issue has a greater punishment than something else where we use the word klal. So Shabbos isa lisser di dabein bedavar shaya talush mi ba'od yom. You can have something that's detached from the ground and you still have an isser. Kagon tochen velush, grinding, kneading, bein bedavar shem mechubar mishakidash yom. Certainly, obviously, something that's attached to the ground, you have many halachas that apply on Shabbos. Ve'ilu shvias bedavar shem mechubar mishakidash shvias isa. The halacha, when shvias takes place, when it takes hold, when it's sanctified, it only applies to things that are mechubar lakarka. Aval bedavar shaya talush lifnei shvias lesser. But if it was already detached from the ground before the Shemitah year, it's not a problem. And then the Gemara said, Shvias nami isa b'maychol behema. Shvias applies by food of animals as well. It says on the Pasuk. Meiser lesi b'maychol behema. When it comes to Meiser, it doesn't apply to Meichel Behema. Demidoraisa dogan tirosh v'yitzhar ksiv. The Pasuk says dogan tirosh v'yitzhar. V'rabbanan tikun peiros ha'ilan v'yerek d'meichel adam. The Rabbanan added on peiros ha'ilan and other vegetables that are human food. Kenektani kol shuocha. That was added on by the Rabbanan. But you don't have, again, it doesn't apply to animal food. So therefore, that's the current answer of why we don't have klal gadol by Meiser, but we have klal gadol by Shabbos and by Shvius. So the Gemara asks, Ulevar kapara detani klal gadol b'Meiser. One second, going back to Bar Kapara. According to Bar Kapara, who does have the terminology of klal gadol by Meiser, so gadol oncho shall Meiser yosem shall paya. So the Gemara says, for that also we have an answer, because the punishment by Meiser is actually greater than by paya. De'ilu Meiser isa b'te'ena v'yerek, because when it comes to Meiser, that applies by figs and other kinds of vegetables. Ve'ilu peya lesa b'te'ena v'yerek, but when it comes to peya, the din again of leaving off the corners of one's field, so that does not apply to figs and to yerek. How do we know that? It's not because we learned in a Mishnah, klal amru b'peya, they said the following rule by peya. And again, here's that lashon of klal. So klal amru b'peya, they say the following rule by peya: kol shu ochel v'nishmar v'gidulo min ha'aretz ulekitaso ka'achas u'machniso l'kiyum chayiv b'peya. Anything that is food and it is guarded and it grows from the ground and you collect it all at once and you bring it in to preserve it for a long time, that's chayiv in peya. And the Gemara now explains this Mishnah: ochel amute svichei stis. Vekotza. Ochel excludes sviche stis vekotza. We'll see Rashi about this. Vinishmar lamute hefkar. Nishmar, the fact that it's protected, that means it has to be something guarded, not something that's hefkar. Otherwise, peya doesn't apply to hefkar. Vigidulo minarz has to grow from the ground. Lamute kmeinu pitrios. That excludes mushrooms and truffles. They don't grow from the ground because they don't really take root. So therefore, they're not considered gidulo minarz. Well, the kitaso ka'achas, it has to be collected in one shot. Lamute te'ena. That's the case of te'ena. It excludes te'ena, which is not all collected at one time. It's not harvested in one gathering. U'machniso l'kiyum, and it has to be brought in to be preserved. L'mu'ute yerek, vegetables do not last a long time. They can't be preserved. So you see that te'ena and yerek, the dinim of peya don't apply. V'ilu gave meiser tanan, but when it comes to meiser, we learned in the Mishnah, Klal amru b'maaser kol shu ochel v'nishmar v'gidulam in ha'aretz. It does say it has to be food and guarded and it has to grow from the ground. Chayiv b'maaser, then it's chayiv in maaser. However, v'ilu l'kitasu ka'achas u'machnisu l'kiyim, whereas the idea that it has to be collected in one shot, harvested in one gathering, and that it has to be brought in and able to be preserved, lo tanan, that we do not find in the Mishnah in maasers. So that's the difference. That's why maaser does have a stringency over peya. So Rashi here explains, first of all, Isa b'te'ein of yerek, it applies by figs and by yerek, this is by maaser midrabanan, that's a din derabanan. Kol shu ochel degave peya katsir ksiv, ma katsir miyuchat sheyesh bo kol eilu. We learn out from this pasuk, katsir has all these qualities. L'me'ute svichei stis v'kotza, Rashi explains what svichei stis v'kotza, she'omdim l'tseva. These are items, these are vegetation that are used to dye. You use them for dyeing wool and other types of cloth. L'hachi nakat svichim, de'ein derech l'loktan b'shanash and izroim, elosof dalet v'hesharim. Svichim are kind of like overgrowth. Those are really only harvested 4 or 5 years after they're planted. Sha'asharash and mispashtin ba'aretz, that's when the roots really extend into the earth. U'mashbichin, and they get nice and they get usable. V'shoresh al anikar, and the main thing you're doing with these things is you're essentially using the root. Now, why do we just choose svichei stis and kotze? Why don't we choose other? There's a lot of things that grow that are vegetation that are not fit for consumption. Mishum da'aydi degabe shvias tani luhu. Since by Shemitah we had this in the list, the Yeshla and Shvias, and it says that that Shvias does apply, Naken Hacha, so therefore we have those same items over here, Devepeya u'maiser lesnu, because they don't apply by Pei and Maiser, Lashon Rabbeinu Halevi, and that is the Lashon of Rabbeinu Halevi. And then again, the Gemara said, "Ve'ilu machniso l'kiyam l'kitasu k'echad lo tanan dechitikon rabbanan adidhu lo plug b'peiros ha'ilanu v'yerek bein min l'min." So when it came to when it comes to maaser, the rabbanan did not want to make any distinction. When it comes to peya, they do make a distinction. However, when it comes to maaser, the rabbanan did not want to make a distinction amongst peiros ha'ilan and yerek between different kind of species, and therefore they did not have this Lakitaso ka'achas exception and this machniso lakim exception by Meiser. The Gemara continues now at the two dots. Rav Ushmuel de Amri Travayu, Rav and Shmuel, they both say as follows. Masnisen betinok shenishba leben hanochrim. Our Mishnah is talking about, again, it's talking about a case, our Mishnah mentions a case where a person doesn't know about Shabbos. So what's the case? So they both say that our Mishnah is talking about either a young child who's Jewish, who's captive amongst the non-Jews, so he doesn't know about Shabbos. And v'ger sheniskayer lebein hanochrim. Also, you can have a case of a ger, someone who converts amongst the non-Jews, again, doesn't know anything about the Ikar Shabbos. Avol hikaru levasof shakach. But if a person knew about Shabbos and he forgot about the entire concept of Shabbos, in such a situation, chayiv al kol Shabbos for Shabbos. He would actually be chayiv on every individual Shabbos. So in other words, the case in the Mishnah where it talks about one chatos for not knowing about Shabbos at all, even though you violate multiple Shabbosos, that's specifically talking about essentially people who never knew about Shabbos, people who knew about Shabbos and then suddenly somehow forgot about the entire concept, they would actually be chayiv on every single Shabbos. Rashi here explains, Mas Nisan, Depater bechad chatas. Our Mishnah, which says that you can get away, get off the hook with one chatas, betinok shenishba v'lo yada Shabbos meolam. Person that didn't know about Shabbos ever. Avol hikur levasof shakach, havalei kishocheach shayom Shabbos. If a person knew about Shabbos, the concept, and then forgot about the concept of Shabbos, that's no different than if he forgot that today is Shabbos. V'yodeyek or Shabbos, and he knew really about the concept of Shabbos. V'chayev al kol Shabbos v'Shabbos. Such a person, again, according to this, would be chayiv on every single Shabbos. So now the Gemara brings the Mishnah to address this point. Tanan, we learned in our Mishnah, Hashocheach Iker Shabbos. It says that if a person forgets the main idea, the concept of Shabbos, that's how it's phrased in the Mishnah. So the Gemara says, Lav Mechlal Dehavalei Yedimei Kara. That doesn't that imply that he did know about Shabbos and he forgot the concept of Shabbos? Exactly, not like Rav and Shmuel are saying. So the Gemara says, "Lo, no. My kol hashocheach ikar Shabbos dohisa shachuach mimenu ikar shel Shabbos." You can translate that phrase not that he forgot, but it was forgotten from him forever. Rashi says, "Shahisa shachuach mimenu meolam." it was forgotten forever from him, that's the situation. Aval hikr levasof shakach, but you can say that if the person knew about Shabbos and then forgot, my what would be the halacha chayiv? I'll call Shabbos for Shabbos. Then he'd be chayiv on every single Shabbos. So the Gemara asks, one second, if that's the case, adetani hayodeya ikr Shabbos v'yosam halachas harbe v'shabbosas harbe chayiv al kol Shabbos for Shabbos. What does the Mishnah say? The next line of the Mishnah says that if you know about Shabbos and you do many melachas on many Shabboses, so you know about the concept of Shabbos, you forget that it's Shabbos, so you're chayav on every single Shabbos. Why give that case? Give a much better case. Listening hikar levasof shakach. Instead, you can give an even bigger chiddush that if the person knew about Shabbos and forgot the entire concept of Shabbos, he'd be chayav on every single Shabbos. V'kol shekein ha. And certainly in this case, you'd be chayav on every Shabbos. In other words, if Rav and Shmuel are correct, that if a person knew about Shabbos and forgot about the concept of Shabbos, that he's chayiv on every single Shabbos, that should be in the Mishnah. And then it's obvious that if the person mamish knows about Shabbos and knows about the concept of Shabbos and keeps violating Shabbos because he forgets the Shabbos, then for sure the person's going to be chayiv on everything, every single Shabbos. So the Gemara says, my hayodeya ikar Shabbos. So no, what does it mean when the Mishnah says that hayodeya ikar Shabbos? It says that the person knows about the ikar Shabbos. It actually means exactly that. Misha hayodeya ikar shal Shabbos v'shachra. It's referring to exactly this case. Somebody who knows about the concept of Shabbos and forgot. That's exactly the case that the Mishnah is actually referring to. Let's take a look at Rashi here. Listening hikar levasof shakach dechayiv. We should have said the case of knowing about Shabbos and then forgetting that you're chayiv. V'af agav delek lemeimar yomim shebensayim havin yediyah lechalik. In that case, you don't even have days in between where there was some kind of possible yediyah, right? The whole idea is you forgot the whole concept of Shabbos. V'chol shekein ha. Certainly in a case where you know about the concept of Shabbos and then every single set of weekdays in between each Shabbos can be a re-remembering and a re-forgetting, so you're chayiv again. So v'chol shekein ha dikla meimar shiyam shabein tayim havin le yediyah lechalik. That's for sure going to be a yediyah, a knowledge to be mechalik. Again, just to understand the concept, the idea is that you're chayiv a korban chatos on each forgetting. So if there is any moment where you can have a yediyah in between, that's essentially mechalik. It divides up and it says, okay, the next forgetting is going to be a new carbon. So what the Gemara was asking was, if even in a case where a person forgot the entire concept of Shabbos, we say that every single Shabbos there's a yediyah lechalik and you have to bring a new chatos. So for sure, when you know the concept of Shabbos and the only issue is you forget that it is Shabbos, so then for sure the days in between could be a yediyah lechalik. That's what it should have said. And the Gemara is essentially answering that that is how you can read the Mishnah. We'll continue with this line in the Gemara on the next Amud on Daf Samech Ches Amud Beis in the next video.